After a commercial U.S. mission to the lunar surface failed last month, another is set to launch from the Kennedy Space Center this week. Key Science is on board as NASA eyes a base on the moon.
Our Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heiler explains why the stakes are so high.
Intuitive Machines hoping its Odysseus lander will be the first U.S. spacecraft to land on the moon in over 50 years. Now set to launch Wednesday morning on a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket from the Kennedy Space Center. Part of NASA's Commercial Lunar Payload Services, or CLPS, to build science and understanding of the moon's surface ahead of coming Artemis missions that will ultimately return humans to the moon.
With a commercial industry comes a competitive environment, which means that our investment up front ultimately gets far more for far less. So instead of one mission in a decade, it allows for more like 10 commercial missions to the moon in a decade.
The focus now is on the South Pole, better chance for water, so early testing and evaluation is critical.
We've got to have a robot there first to kind of pave the way to really understand what these landing sites are, and these can be then potential landing sites for future astronaut missions.
Some of the science and studies on IM-1 will provide data for safe landings, photos of the surface impact when the lander touches down, and the testing of laser guiding systems.
We can't always expect that the first of any new type of spacecraft or space mission will be fully successful, but we can hope that we can build and move towards more and more successes.
If the mission goes as planned, the lander will touch down on February 22nd. It'll also be carrying payloads for other paying customers. As with missions up to the International Space Station, this private industry NASA partnership steps up the pace. It's good for progress, but also critical for setting up on the moon.
This is going to be a very competitive landscape here in the next decade or so, and the U.S. can't afford to really fall behind.
On the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.
Those amazing graphics of the lunar lander and Scott's story are thanks to the Houston Chronicle and their 3D project on this mission. We'll have a link to their project and this story on our website, WESH.com.